Boyer. The condition of feeling like a city that's most interesting for its ruins. Nye, the becoming Aragon of the paragonal discourse of evaluation. The curated cultures chapter is strong and could stand alone as a structural and materialist analysis of burgeoning museums grappling with colonial histories. The National Gallery of Singapore is used as a case study of an alternative to the universal museums in the West and to the nationalized post-colonial museums that particularize colonialized locales in ethnographic miniature. Two colonial era buildings of administrative power, a city hall and a court building, are linked by an atrium and stratified above and below with museological amenities. Where Joslit declares an appropriation of the colonial buildings as ready-mades in service of a cultural excavation and site for reimagining Singaporean identity, it's hard not to see a papering over of consolidated power and the museum as the continued site for the realization of the hegemony side of the curatorial episteme. There's a conceptual or associational schism where signifiers become wildly divergent based on discourses contained within. This leads to the appropriation of other signifiers to begin anew the demarcation of a site of association or discourse that tends towards the exceeding of that signifier's capacity. Or, that makes me glass, soft glass bending in long meadows, a fallacy each generation reinvents and disavows, a rocking motion, says Lerner in the media. So if these words fall further from their time towards oblivion, maybe these images can moor them to these fleeting feelings. Depth is computed as an absence, a non-visible differential between two positions, the illusionistic space of perspective, data gleaned from penetrating waves, the compounding volumes of anisotropic data collected through instrumental logics, assembles in dangerous effigy, the vestiges of ethics and ecology alienated from meaning. As I progress through Heritage and Debt, it becomes unclear if I'm reading Joslit, the critic of neoliberal art markets and a history of Euro-American supremacist colonization and canon making, or Joslit, the consultant of contemporary museology towards the realization of soft power, art world contemporaneity, cultural capital, an entree to post-industrial knowledge-based economies in special economic and symbolic zones. We could call this catachresis, intellectual cashmere for gentile Marxists. We bring a small Bluetooth speaker into the convertible for our drive.